This is a reflection of the fact that it is much broader than the binary, which is amazing.
Dozens of BC government regulations no longer have words like he, her, brother, or wife. It's a welcome change from the executive director of Options for Sexual Health, who explains why words matter.
What it is limiting, right? It's very important that we get to see ourselves in the world. And so the idea that we'll be talking about people or humans or folk, which includes everybody and doesn't exclude anyone, is incredibly important.
Michelle Fortin says she's not surprised by the BC government's recent announcement of removing around 600 instances of gendered language from nearly 70 provincial regulations.
I think it's also important to know that I make mistakes. I make mistakes and I am heavily, saturated in this world. We're all going to make mistakes. We just need to recognize it and move on.
Minister of Jobs, Economic Recovery and Innovation Ravi Kallon says it's an effort to include all gender identities and to ensure all British Columbians have equal access to government services.
Words matter. So we owe it to every British Columbian to both reframe our language, but also ensure that we're gender inclusive in our language as well as policies.
And to those who may be wondering why a change like this is necessary.
If you haven't felt discrimination or if you haven't seen yourself excluded, maybe you immediately won't understand why it's important, but talk to someone who has and they'll tell you why these important changes are so critical.
I think one of the things that happens, especially for older folks, for folks that are, straight and cis, is that they are struggling because they're learning something new. So I think it's our responsibility to create the space for them to learn.
Moving forward, the provincial government plans to remove around 3,400 remaining instances of gendered language in regulations and legislation.
This last year in particular has given people really an opportunity to think about what's important.
In Vancouver, Miranda Fatur, City News.